Welcome to another video, and today I will be going over the new features I added in the SignFun customizer. The update includes some bug fixes and some other various things. One thing I've changed in the update is you can just do /new like this, and then the name and the XP cost is optional. You can do just the XP calls, or you can also just do the name, or of course you can do both, or like I said, you can just do new and it'll create one. Here I have added I've changed some of the buttons. Here's the XP cost. You click it, and then you have to click this. And then you just enter the XP cost. And then here's the name. Since you didn't have an item in your hand and you didn't give it a name, it generated a random one. But we need a better name than that. So we can change this to like use items. And it will change the name. And everything works as put the recipe here and the what you want it to make here. And then here's the there's a recipe I did, and you can change the name and stuff on here too. Another feature I added is the item editor, and I'll show you what that looks like. Let me get a sword. We'll do it with a sword. And just put your item here you want to edit. And you can click here to change the name of it. And here's all the enchants available. And right now it's set on 1. And so again, you just come down here and click the input. Let's do it to 120. And now you left click to add it. So we're just going to add everything. And like if you didn't want the curse of vanishing on there, you just come here and right click and it removes it. And I can sit here and remove all this if I wanted to. Add a couple of things back on here. And also here is the attributes. This button, you just click it and it what slot it has to be equipped for. Of course a sword is going to be in the main hand. Here's the just like the before, you can change the number. Let's do it to 1.2. And we can add attack damage, speed, health, movement, armor, and luck. And then to clear it, the same thing, you just right click and it's the movement, speed, and look off of it. And armor. So we get that. These buttons, and of course you can hit clear all and it will clear all the attributes off. But let's go ahead and just do some. Yeah, I didn't tell. Of course, you can add something if they have it in offhand. We can do movement speed. So if it's an offhand, it does movement speed. If it's in the main hand, it does max health, attack damage, and attack speed. Here's some lore. Just click the thing. Now we got some more. Here, let's change that. There we go. And to remove, you can either clear it all, like we did before, or you can click remove lore. And you simply click which line you want to remove. We want to clear the first line, so we just click that and enter. There you go. Now you have your lure and your enchant. And then you just take it out, and then we can go back to the editor. And that's another thing that I didn't mention before. If you just do FFC, it goes back to your current editor. And so, but if you want to do a new one, you do new. It'll come up there. And of course, you can do here and then make your recipe and then add it to Slime Fun, which is in another video. There's one more feature in the editor that I didn't go over, and that's this button. And bringing up a website. You can add custom head tech, custom graphics to your heads. There's a website. There it is. Minecraft heads. This is what I use. I'm sure there's other websites. And you can just come here and you can pick your texture. Let's do an alphabet. There you go. I'll do this one. If you do the give code, you want this value here. It says value in quotes. You just want to copy that. And then you simply click. Again, just click on this input, paste it in, and hit enter. And then there is your custom head there. And of course, you can edit it. You can change the name to it. And you can add enchants and stuff. You can add attributes, which will work. I'm going to and then future update, I will add hopefully some commands. So if they use the block or click the block or place it, it'll run a command. But that's in another update for future times. And I hope it's this has been very useful. And as always, you can use the you can still use the old commands, the lore, enchant, and attributes and color. If you don't want to use the item editor, I just thought I'd make it more convenient and more useful for players. Thank you for watching.